Hello, welcome to the News Digest. This week with me, Vivian Kamsimi. We are here at the National Curriculum Development Center to speak to the Deputy Director, Dr. Bernadette Nambi Karuhanga, about the new A-level curriculum, which is supposed to make Ugandans or candidates at that level more employable. Thank you for joining us, Doctor. The current curriculum is 100 years. What took us so long? Aren't we late?
It's never too late to have the amendments effected. And maybe before I proceed, my name is Bernadette Nambi Karuhanga. I'm the Deputy Director in charge of academics at NCDC. Yes, it's true, we have never reviewed the A-level curriculum since colonial times. And that has been because of many other issues. But we also are aware that right now a lot of changes are going on, not only in Uganda, but also in Africa and the world over, where most of the education institutions and governments and sectors are moving away from objective-based curricula to competence-based curricula. And they are focusing more on the learners as opposed to the previous curriculum, which emphasizes the teacher as the center of the teaching learning process. So this has occurred in the recent past, the change from a teacher-centered to a learner-centered curriculum, the emphasis on competence-based approaches, the emphasis on learner interactivity, and therefore we are not late. It is timely. And as you're aware, we rolled out our lower secondary curriculum, which is competence-based, in 2020. We had, prior to that, rolled out the primary curriculum, which is also competence-based, from 2007 to 2013, because we did it in a phased-out manner. We also had developed earlier on the ECD learning framework, which is like the curriculum guiding the nursery section, which is also competence-based. So considering that we had already done a review of those curricula at those levels, it is timely that we now need to embark on the review of the A-level curriculum to align it with the other curricula, but also to align it with the changes that are ongoing elsewhere in the world.
The O-level curriculum is learner-centered. What are you hoping to achieve with this new A-level curriculum?
When we rolled out the O-level curriculum, the intention was to ensure that our learners are equipped with the required skills, knowledge, attitudes, and values relevant for the 21st century. The same thinking came out when we conducted a needs assessment, because before you embark on development of the curriculum, you need to conduct a needs assessment, find out what the stakeholders' views are. You don't just sit and do the curriculum. So we conducted the needs assessment with many stakeholders across the country, and they felt that there was also need to review the A-level curriculum to make it more practical, to vocationalize it, to make it competence-based, to remove redundancies, to remove repetitions, but most importantly, to ensure that the product that is coming out to the market is that product who has the abilities to innovate, to be self-reliant, to be patriotic, and who is morally upright. So basically, that is the focus. Whatever it is that we are going to package in this curriculum based on stakeholder submissions is geared towards the achievement of that kind of output in terms of the person we are looking at.
You have talked about removing irrelevancies. Are there combinations you are going to remove? Maybe HEL, that is History, Economics and Literature, PCB, maybe. Are there subjects you're going to remove at A-level now?
At this point in time, we may not be specific on that because we are still conducting stakeholder consultations to get views from the public, to find out what they think about the curriculum menu. But ideally, all the subjects, most of the subjects that are currently in place are still in place. According to the stakeholders, they feel that the subjects are still relevant, but then it will be in the content and the methodology where we shall have the bigger changes. But of course, within those subjects, there may be repetitions here and there. Those we want to get rid of them. But in terms of the curriculum menu in itself, almost all subjects that are in place right now are still relevant and appreciated according to the stakeholders. But we are still conducting consultations and we are yet to come up with the final position on that. So I don't want to say at this point in time, it's in the early stages, that this is what it is that we shall be packaging for the learners.
You are talking about introducing vocational skills. Those are practical skills. How are you hoping to meet the job market with this new curriculum?
We are hoping that when we vocationalize the curriculum, it will help us greatly to equip the learners with the practical skills to do something for themselves, but also the soft skills, which we call the generic skills, to be able to compete favorably in the 21st century. We are thinking about things like communication skills, things like emotional intelligence. You know, you can be a very smart person, but if you cannot control, for example, your emotions, if you cannot be in position to manage yourself, then you may find yourself even failing to be at the workplace. So we are saying that we want learners who have the innovations, learners who are able to do, to apply the knowledge that they have learnt in class, as opposed to just reading, pass with an A, but when you get to the university, you cannot defend that A.
From Dr. Bernadette here, the new A-level curriculum sounds very exciting, as the learner will be very well prepared for the job market. Thank you for watching us this week. Until next week on Thursday, the News Digest.